all of us are knowing about the terms resistor, inductor and capacitor. And we have come across an AC circuit containing only resistor, an AC circuit containing only inductor and an AC circuit containing only capacitor. Have you ever thought in our household and industries, we are using the combination of all these three? So what is the mode of connection and what it is called? So today's topic is RLC series circuit. And the key points which will be discussed here are components of RLC series circuit, its usage, impedance, graph of I versus frequency and numerical. So to start with, resistor, inductor and capacitor. You can see all these are connected in series. And this is your AC supply voltage, which is given here E equals to E naught sin omega t. Omega being the angular frequency, E naught is the maximum voltage. Children, when we are learning about any topic, it should always be in the back of your mind, what is the reason of studying this? So let us know the use of RLC series circuit. They are used in radio and televisions for tuning to select a particular narrow range of frequency from the ambient radio waves. Now let us see the voltage in each of these components. For resistor, VR equals to IR. For inductor, VL equals to IXL. For capacitor, VC is equal to IXC. R is of course resistance. XL is your inductive reactance. XC is your capacitive reactance. And XL equals to omega L. XC equals to 1 upon omega C. Omega being the angular frequency. L is the inductance and C is the capacitor. Now in the case of resistor, both I and V are in same phase. So phase difference will be 0 over here. For inductor, V leads I. So phase difference is 90 degree and it is positive. And in the case of capacitor, voltage lags behind the current by 90 degree. So phase difference phi equals to 90 degree and it is negative. Now what if I want to add all these three voltages? Because the net voltage E naught will be equal to VR, VL and VC. All these three cannot be added geometrically or algebraically because there are differences in their phase. So what is the mode of addition? Let us see that. Now let us see the phasor diagram. VR and I both are in same phase. VL is in positive region. VC is in the negative region. This is also 90 degree and here this is also 90 degree. Now if VL is equal to 10 units and VC be 5 units, and now because they are lying in the same straight line, they can be added. So I can cut this 5 units on this VL to get VL minus VC. Because they are in the same straight line, this VL and VC can be added together to get VL minus VC. We are getting now two vectors. This is your VR and this is your VL minus VC. So these two can be added by parallelogram law of addition. This gives you the resultant, that is E naught. This will be also VL minus VC. So in the case where VL is greater than VC, what will be I equal to? E was E naught sin omega t. So in this case, I will be equal to I naught sin omega t minus phi. because current is lagging behind. There is a phase difference of phi. Now, if VC is greater than VL, then in this case, what will happen to the current? I naught sine omega t plus phi. Because in this case, current is leading by the phase difference of phi. Now, if in a triangle, these sides are divided by a similar quantity, then the ratio will not change and we will get a similar triangle. Let us see that similar triangle. VR divided by I gives R. VL divided by I gives us XL. And VC divided by I gives us XC. So this is the similar triangle. R and XL minus XC are the two sides of this triangle, and this is called the resultant. So what will be this value of resultant and what it is called? Now you see here, R is also opposing current, XL minus XC are also opposing the current, so this resultant will also oppose the current. That is, it impedes the current or decreases the current, and this is called impedance, which is denoted by the letter Z. What will be the SI unit of it, children? Of course, it is opposing the current, so its SI unit will be also ohm, same. Ohm. Now, variation of Z, how it varies and how it is related to current. In this impedance triangle, Z will be equal to R square plus XL minus XC whole square. Now, variation of Z. We have to see how does this Z vary. How to keep it minimum. Because I naught Z, E naught is equal to I naught Z. So, I naught will be equal to E naught upon Z. So, for the maximum current, impedance should be minimum. From this you can see R cannot be 0, XL cannot be 0, even XC cannot be 0. But XL minus XC can be 0. So if XL minus XC is 0, that means XL is equal to XC. What is XL? Omega L is equal to 1 upon omega C. So, omega equals to 1 upon root over LC. This omega, we call it omega naught, and this is called natural frequency. Now, if the supply voltage is equal to natural frequency, then in this case, XL will be equal to XC. Phi is 0. Now, if angular frequency which you are supplying is greater than the natural frequency, then in this case, XL will be exceeding this XC. That means this gap is your XL minus XC. And phase difference will be your 90 degree and it is positive. Now in this case where angular frequency is less than the natural frequency, then in this case what happens? XL is behind XC. XC is exceeding XL. That means here also of course phi will be 90 degree and it is negative. Now to draw the graph. If we plot a graph of current versus angular frequency, on the y-axis we are taking current and on the x-axis we are taking omega. If your supply voltage, as we discussed just now, is equal to omega naught, then the current will be maximum. So this will be your I naught. And if I'm taking here omega less than omega naught and I'm taking here omega greater than omega naught, in these two cases current will be somewhere here, moderate current. So the graph will be of this form. Now any topic without a numerical is incomplete. So let us discuss one of the numerical, others will be discussed in the other classes. A capacitor of 100 microfarad and a coil of a resistance 50 ohm and inductance 0.5 henry are connected in series with a 110 volt and 50 hertz source. Calculate the RMS value of current in the circuit. Now the things given here are C equals to 100 microfarad, which you can change it in farad. Resistance equal to 50 ohm and EV equals to 100 volt, L equals to 0.5H, frequency equals to 50 hertz. So for finding Z, first we need to find IV. So XC equals to 1 upon omega C, this comes out to be 1 upon 2 pi nu C, which by substituting the values we are getting 31.85 omega. Similarly, XL equals to omega L. And again by putting all the values, we get XL equals to 157 ohm. Now the formula for impedance is this. So put the values over here. R equals to 50, XL 157, XC 31.85. And then on solving, we get 134.77 ohms. Now for finding the virtual value of I. IV will be equal to EV upon Z. EV is already given 110. So divided by 134.77, we get 0.816 ampere. This is the answer. So I hope the topic must be very clear to you all. By more practice of numericals, the topic will be more easy for you. Thank you, children.